गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. ऑल ऑफ यू हैव रिटन द नोट्स ऑफ एक्टिव पैसिव इन योर कॉपीज.
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
तो those who have not written, I have sent all the notes on the class WhatsApp group. WhatsApp group पे सब कुछ दोबारा भेज दिए. The class के time, if you have missed, you can write it again. So today we will study this chapter, A Truly Beautiful Mind. And this chapter is about the life of Albert Einstein. All of you have heard his name? Hello? Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
You have heard Albert Einstein's name?
Yes.
What is he famous for?
Theory of relativity, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Theory of relativity. And he is a genius. Means he has a very intelligent brain, one of the most intelligent brains. So who do you think of when you hear the word genius? Who is a genius? Genius is a person who has a very intelligent brain. All of you mute yourselves. Mute yourselves, all of you. Einstein was a genius, very, very intelligent person. We shall now read about a young German civil servant who took the world by storm about 100 years ago. Took the world by storm matlab kya? Ki duniya mein tehalka macha diya unhone. Took the world by storm, it is an idiomatic expression. Or what is the meaning of it? कि दुनिया में तहलका मचा देना, कुछ ऐसा उन्होंने खोजा. He discovered something new and that changed the whole world 100 years ago in the summer of 1905. The 26-year-old published in quick succession 4 groundbreaking papers. So in the year 1905, when Einstein was 26 years old, he published 4 groundbreaking papers. Means he published his articles. Yeah, papers means articles about light, the motion of particles, the electrodynamics of moving bodies and energy. He published all these groundbreaking papers: light, motion of particles, electrodynamics of moving bodies and energy. His work took up only a few pages in journals. But changed forever our understanding of space, time, and the entire cosmos. So before that, people had some other theory about space, time, and entire cosmos. But after Einstein published these 4 articles, what happened? It changed. It changed their concept. After Einstein published these 4 articles about the light, motion of particles, the electrodynamics of moving bodies and energy, he changed the understanding, the concept of space, time, and the entire cosmos, and transformed the name Einstein into a synonym of genius. Synonym means, you know. Hello? Synonym? Hello, can you hear me, all of you? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Synonym, antonym. Antonym means kya hota?
Hum us word ka opposite.
Kya?
Hum wo jo word
hai. Hum us word ka ulta.
वेरी गुड.
और सिनोनिम्स मतलब उस वर्ड से जो मिलता जुलता वर्ड है वो सब.
वेरी गुड. सिनोनिम मीन्स
जिसका मीनिंग
सेम मीनिंग. पर्यायवाची शब्द हिंदी में पढ़े हो ना, पर्यायवाची शब्द पढ़ते हो ना, जल नीर तो कमल पंकज, तो ये सब क्या है सिनोनिम. सिनोनिम मीन्स द वर्ड्स दैट हैव द सेम मीनिंग. सो आइंस्टाइन मीन्स जीनियस. Einstein's genius became the meaning of Einstein's name 50 years after his death. Einstein's genius still reigns. Einstein's genius still reigns. Rain means what? R-E-I-G and rain, it's pronounced as rain. G is silent. What is the meaning? Anyone can tell the meaning of rain? History में वो ये word पढ़े हो कभी?
No. मैम छा जाना.
छा जाना.
मैम rain का मतलब?
Rain, R-E-I-G-N जो ये last word है ना.
मैम उनके समय में. उनके समय में. मैम उनके दौरान समय में.
राज करना. राज करना. During Akbar's reign. पढ़ते हो ना हिस्ट्री में, ड्यूरिंग सो एंड सो किंग्स रेन, ड्यूरिंग मोदीज रेन मींस
रूलिंग.
ओके, सो आइंस्टाइन स्टिल रूल्स द वर्ल्ड, हिज जीनियस स्टिल रूल्स द वर्ल्ड, बिकॉज वट एवर ही डिस्कवर्ड इट इज यूजफुल इवन इन टूडेज वर्ल्ड. सो दैट इज वाई we are benefiting by his genius even today. Einstein, Albert Einstein's genius still reigns. So Albert Einstein was born on 14 March 1879 in the German city of Ulm. So now we will study about his life. When was he born? On 14th March 1879 in the German city of Ulm, without any indication that he was destined for greatness. Means when Einstein was born, there was no indication that he would be a great person one day. Indication matlab bachpan mein koi aisa sanket nahi tha. What does it mean? Ki जब वो पैदा हुए तो नॉर्मल बच्चे के तरह थे, कोई भी संकेत ऐसा नहीं था कि वो एक दिन जो है इतने बड़े जीनियस बनेंगे. सो देयर वाज नो इंडिकेशन दैट ही वाज डेस्टिन्ड फॉर ग्रेटनेस. ऑन द कॉन्ट्ररी हिज मदर थॉट अल्बर्ट वाज अ फ्रीक. ऑन द कॉन्ट्ररी मींस अपोजिट टू दिस. आइंस्टाइन मदर thought that he was a freak. Freak means very unusual person, strange person, jiska vyavhar bahut ajeeb ho. Freak means what? A word used disapprovingly to talk about a person who is unusual and doesn't behave, look or think like others. Matlab kya? Jiska vyavhar thoda ajeeb ho, normal se thoda hatke. So what did Einstein's mother think about him? That his behavior was very strange. Einstein's mother thought that he was a boy with strange behavior. Normal se kuch hatke tha wo. To her, his head seemed too large. And Einstein's physical appearance was also strange. What was strange about his physical appearance? Unke body mein sabse bada part kya tha? Unka sar. So what was strange about Einstein's physical appearance? It was that he had a very big head. The strange thing about Einstein's physical appearance was that his head was bigger as compared to his body. And can you hear me? All of you? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, at the age of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. So, another
good morning,
strange thing. Good morning, all of you. Good morning. Did you encourage your friends to join the classes yesterday? I told you.
Yes.
इतने लोगों yes, ने किया है. सही सही बताओ.
मैम हम किए हैं.
किए हो.
मैम almost 10.
चलो थैंक यू जो लोग भी किए हैं चलो थैंक. At the age of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. So
ma'am,
when he was when he was 2.5 years old, आप बोलो कोई कुछ पूछना चाहते हो?
मैम नोट्स भेज दीजिए.
हाँ नोट्स तो हम भेज दिए हैं ग्रामर का दोनों एक्टिव पैसिव वॉइस का दो दिन पढ़ाए दोनों का नोट्स.
मैम आज का
आज का आज तो दिस इज ऑडियो ऑडियो आई विल सेंड.
यस मैम.
सो To, at the age of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. When he finally learned to speak, when he finally did learn to speak, he uttered everything twice. तो और Einstein जो है वो बोलना भी जो है वो देर से सीखे. Normally, when does a child start speaking? Tell me. बच्चा बोलना कब start करता है? Normally जो
हम डेढ़ साल में
डेढ़ साल से पहले ही वो बोलना स्टार्ट कर दे. आठ नौ महीने का होता है तो कुछ अच्छा ये सब तो बोलता है बच्चा एकदम. तो लेकिन आइंस्टाइन जो है वो आइंस्टाइन स्टार्टेड स्पीकिंग वेरी लेट 2.5 इयर्स. At the age of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. When he finally did learn to speak, he uttered everything twice. हाँ कुछ पूछ रहे हो?
मैं म्यूट कर दीजिए सब इतना चिल्ला रहे.
Yeah.
Okay, कर दे रहा. Mute yourselves, all of you. ये क्या तुम लोग अनम्यूट क्यों कर लेते हो?
हम सब हल्ला कर रहे.
म्यूट योरसेल्फ.
जितेंद्र कुमार मैम म्यूट.
सो
यस मैम.
Otto Neuberger, the historian of ancient mathematics, told a story about the boy Einstein that he characterizes as a legend. But that seems fairly authentic. He's a legend, means a very famous person. As he was a late talker, his parents were worried. So it's natural. Any parent will become worried if child does not speak till the age of 2.5 years. It is natural that the parent will seem worried. As he was late talker, his parents were worried. At last, at the supper table one night, he broke his silence to say, "The soup is too hot." So, सबसे पहला जो sentence Einstein ने बोला था, वो क्या? ये chapter का part नहीं है, ऐसे ही एक extra चीज I'm telling you. So, when did he first start speaking? He first started speaking at the supper table. Supper, you understand? What is the meaning of supper? Supper ka meaning bata?
Yes, ma'am.
Kya bolo? Hello. Hello, what is the meaning of supper? Hello. Nobody?
Sham ka khana. Huh? Sham ka khana. Ma'am, sham ka khana.
Raat ka khana. सफर मतलब डिनर रात का खाना. तो एक दिन मतलब सबसे पहला हाँ रात सफर मींस डिनर द मील दैट यू टेक एट नाइट. सो एट लास्ट एट द सफर टेबल वन नाइट ही ब्रोक हिज साइलेंस टू से द सूप इज टू हॉट. एंड व्हाट वाज द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस दैट ही स्पोक? द सूप इज टू हॉट. ग्रेटली रिलीव्ड हिज पेरेंट्स व्हाई asked why he had never said a word. और parents के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा राहत था कि चलो Einstein ने बोलना तो सीखा. Relieved, relaxed. Albert replied because up to now everything was in order. उसने कहा कि अभी तक जो है सब कुछ ठीक था इसीलिए कुछ नहीं बोला.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग. एट द देन एंड व्हेन ही लर्न टू स्पीक व्हाट हैपेंड. वो हर बात को जो है दो बार बोलते थे. ही अटर्ड. अटर्ड मींस स्पोक. राइट द मीनिंग ऑफ अटर्ड. अटर्ड मींस स्पोक. He uttered everything twice. Einstein did not know what to do with other children, and his playmates called him brother boring. और क्या क्या चीज स्ट्रेंज था आइंस्टाइन के बारे में कि he did not have friends. He did not have any friends. He did not know what to do with other children. दूसरे बच्चों से बात करें क्या करें. तो he did not have any friends. And so his playmates मतलब जो साथ खेला करते थे उन्होंने आइंस्टाइन को क्या नाम दिया. ब्रदर बोरिंग. What did his friends call Einstein? Brother boring. ऐसा क्यों? क्योंकि आइंस्टाइन did not mix up with the other children. He always remained very aloof. He could not mix up with other children, and so the other children thought that he was a very boring person. And his playmates called him brother boring. These are the strange things about Einstein. First, that his head is bigger than his body, and he was a freak according to his mother. Very strange behavior, unusual behavior. Then he did not mix up with his friends. And he spoke very late in his childhood. These are the strange things about him. And he did not have any friend at all. And his friends called him a boring person. वो हंसते बोलते नहीं थे दूसरों के साथ. Enjoy नहीं करते थे. अपने feelings को share नहीं करते थे. तो his friends found him very boring. And they called him by the name brother boring. So the youngster played by himself. So what did Einstein do? He used to play all by himself much of the time. Much of the time he played all by himself. अकेले ही वो खेला करते थे. He especially loved mechanical toys. And what kind of toys he loved? Mechanical toys. जिसमें कुछ machinery fix हो. तो he especially loved mechanical toys. Looking at his newborn sister Maja, he is said to have said, "Fine, but where are her wheels?" So this is very, funny, humorous comment. The first time he saw his newborn sister, what comment he made about her? कि इसके पहिए कहाँ हैं? Because he did not know that he did not see her feet at first. And he commented about her that where are her wheels. So this is a very funny comment that Einstein gave when he saw his newborn sister. Where are her wheels? Can you hear me, all of you? Hello? Hello?
Yes, hello? Ma'am.
Okay. A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter because he'll never make a success at anything. और आइंस्टाइन के जो प्रिंसिपल थे उन्होंने आइंस्टाइन के बारे में एक बहुत नेगेटिव कमेंट दिया था बचपन में. उन्होंने क्या कहा था आइंस्टाइन के बारे में कि आइंस्टाइन किसी भी काम में सफल नहीं हो सकते हैं. सो The principal had given a very negative comment about Einstein. What was it? That Einstein would not be successful at anything. A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter. कोई भी profession ले, Einstein successful नहीं हो सकते. Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6. Because his mother wanted him to do so. Then Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6. माँ ने आइंस्टाइन को एक नए हॉबी में इंटरेस्ट जगाया. हाँ वो था टू प्ले द वायलिन. सो आइंस्टाइन्स मदर डेवलप द इंटरेस्ट इन आइंस्टाइन of playing the violin. Began learning to play the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted him to. So Einstein started playing the violin because of his mother. He later became a gifted amateur violinist. Amateur means doing something for personal enjoyment rather than as a profession. It is pronounced amateur. So what does it mean? जो काम हम सिर्फ अपने enjoyment के लिए करते हैं, पैसा कमाने के लिए नहीं, उसको amateur कहते हैं. होता है ना, कुछ कुछ जॉब जो है पैसा कमाने के लिए करते हैं, लेकिन यू डू सम ऑफ द थिंग्स फॉर योर ओन प्लेजर, दैट इज amateur. समथिंग दैट यू डू जस्ट फॉर हैप्पीनेस एंड एंजॉयमेंट, नॉट फॉर अर्निंग मनी. सो ही स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग अ वायलिन एंड ही वॉज ऑल्सो गुड वायलिनिस्ट, बट ही डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू मेक that his profession. It was just his hobby. Playing violin was his hobby. And this interest was inculcated in Einstein by his mother, maintaining his skill throughout his life. Or scientist to the hi Einstein. Violin bajana bhi wo lagatar chalta raha unke life mein. But Albert Einstein was not a bad pupil. Pupil means student. एक pupil होता है आँख का pupil, लेकिन यहाँ English में contextual meaning होता है. बहुत सारा words, there are many words which have the same spelling, but their meanings are different. Bark, bark, bark of a tree, bark of a dog. तो यहाँ pupil जो है यहाँ इस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में प्यूपल का मीनिंग है स्टूडेंट. सो आइंस्टाइन वाज नॉट अ बैड स्टूडेंट. ही वेंट टू हाई स्कूल इन म्यूनिक. म्यूनिक इज द नेम ऑफ द प्लेस. सो आइंस्टाइन स्टडीड इन म्यूनिक, वेयर आइंस्टाइन्स फैमिली हैड मूव्ड व्हेन ही वाज 15 मंथ्स ओल्ड. सो आइंस्टाइन्स फैमिली हैड मूव्ड टू म्यूनिक व्हेन ही वाज जस्ट 15 मंथ्स ओल्ड. And scored good marks in almost every subject. So Einstein was a good student. He was not a bad student. And he studied in the school in Munich when he was 15 months old and scored good marks in almost every subject. Einstein hated the school's regimentation and often clashed with his teachers. So Einstein did not like the strict discipline of the school. आइंस्टाइन को स्कूल का क्या चीज बहुत खराब लगता था, उसका स्ट्रिक्ट डिसिप्लिन. हेटेड द स्कूल्स स्ट्रिक्ट डिसिप्लिन एंड ही ऑफन आर्ग्यूड विथ हिज टीचर्स. क्लैश्ड मींस व्हाट? क्लैश्ड मींस आर्ग्यूड, झगड़ा करना, मतलब एक तरह से आर्ग्यू करना. तो At the age of 15, Einstein felt so stifled there that he left the school for good. Stifled means suffocated. कोई बंधन में बंधे रहना. तो Einstein ने 15 years में school छोड़ दिया. Why? What was the reason? Can anyone tell me what was the reason why Einstein left school? Hello? Hello, can you hear me, all of you? Hello?
But the strict discipline of the
school. Yes, why did Einstein leave school at the age of 15? What did he dislike about the school?
The strict discipline.
Yes, very good.
Because of the strict discipline of this school.
Because of the strict
discipline. Of this.
And also he had an argument with his teacher. It's not mentioned in the chapter, but Einstein actually argued with the history teacher. हिस्ट्री टीचर ने आइंस्टाइन से कोई डेट पूछा, तो आइंस्टाइन सेड दैट व्हाई शुड आई मेमोराइज द डेट्स, मेमोराइजिंग डेट्स इज यूजलेस बिकॉज इट इज ऑलवेज देयर इन द बुक्स. सो वन थिंग दैट आइंस्टाइन वाज अगेंस्ट इज रोट मेमोरी. आइंस्टाइन जो है वो किसी चीज को रटने के खिलाफ थे, दैट मेमोराइजिंग एनीथिंग इज यूजलेस अकॉर्डिंग टू आइंस्टाइन. तो यहाँ मेंशन है ना कि क्लैश, तो क्लैश एक्चुअली उनका हुआ था अपने हिस्ट्री टीचर से. टीचर नेचुरली गॉट वेरी एंग्री, ही इज आर्ग्यूइंग विद द टीचर, व्हाई शुड आई लर्न द डेट्स, इट्स यूजलेस, इट इज ऑलवेज देयर इन द बुक्स. सो द हिस्ट्री टीचर गॉट एंग्री एंड ही पनिश्ड हिम एंड देन ट्रबल स्टार्टेड. और फिर आइंस्टाइन को एक जो है फेक मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट बनवाना पड़ा स्कूल से निकलने के लिए, दैट इज मेंटली अनसाउंड. अब कोई भी स्टूडेंट है, इफ द स्टूडेंट विल टेल हिज पेरेंट्स आई डोंट लाइक द डिसिप्लिन ऑफ द स्कूल एंड आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू बी इन द स्कूल, विल द पेरेंट अग्री एंड रिमूव द चाइल्ड? कोई पेरेंट ऐसा करेंगे कि डिसिप्लिन पसंद नहीं है तो स्कूल छोड़ दो?
नो मैम,
नो. तो आइंस्टाइन को स्कूल में पढ़ना नहीं था और पेरेंट तो वो उसको स्कूल में जबरदस्ती पढ़वाते. और तो आइंस्टाइन व्हाट ही डिड इज ही हैड अ कजिन एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द कजिन ही कॉन्टेक्टेड अ मेडिकल स्टूडेंट एंड ही टोल्ड हिम टू गिव हिम अ मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट दैट इज ही इज मेंटली अनस्टेबल. और इस तरह से जो है फिर वो स्कूल अपना बदले. वो this is also not mentioned in the book, this is just an extra information that I'm giving. At the age of 15, Einstein, the previous year Einstein's parents had moved to Milan. Milan is also name of the place, Munich. Phir 15 साल में आइंस्टाइन ने अपना स्कूल छोड़ दिया अपने अच्छे के लिए. स्कूल में उनको मन नहीं लगता था, झगड़ा होता था टीचर के साथ, तो क्या ये था. द प्रीवियस ईयर एल्बर्ट्स पेरेंट्स हैड मूव्ड टू मिलन एंड लेफ्ट देयर सन विथ रिलेटिव्स. सो एल्बर्ट्स पेरेंट्स मूव टू अ न्यू प्लेस. और एल्बर्ट को कहाँ छोड़ दिया? अपने रिश्तेदारों के साथ. आफ्टर प्रोलॉन्ग्ड डिस्कशन, प्रोलॉन्ग्ड मीन्स लॉन्ग, लंबा, Einstein got his wish to continue his education in German speaking Switzerland, in a city which was more liberal than Munich. So Einstein ne ek naya school mein admission liya, German speaking Switzerland, and this time he took admission in Switzerland. And what was the reason why he took एडमिशन म्यूनिख के स्कूल से निकल के स्विट्जरलैंड के स्कूल में क्यों एडमिशन लिया? विलिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, लिबरल मीन्स विलिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड रिस्पेक्ट अदर्स. व्हाई डिड आइंस्टाइन टेक एडमिशन इन द स्कूल इन स्विट्जरलैंड? दोनों तो स्कूल ही था, क्या अंतर था स्विट्जरलैंड के स्कूल में और म्यूनिख के स्कूल में? बोलो, I want to make the class interactive. Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Why did Einstein take admission in the school in Switzerland? He left the
ma'am,
school.
He took admission in the Switzerland school because it was more liberal.
Yes, very good. It was more liberal. Switzerland के school में जो है वैसा strict discipline नहीं था. Students को भी थोड़ी बहुत freedom दी जाती थी. Students के childhood को थोड़ा respect मिलता था. So, willing to understand and respect others. Liberal means willing to understand and respect others. So, Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics. So, Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics. So, what were Einstein's? Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics, and after finishing school he decided to study at a university in Zurich. So Einstein had a very intelligent brain and his brain was specially gifted in mathematics and physics. So he had special interest in two subjects, that was mathematics and physics. And after finishing school, he decided to study at a university in Zurich. तो स्विट्जरलैंड में आइंस्टाइन ने अपने स्कूल की पढ़ाई को पूरा किया एंड ही टुक एडमिशन इन द कॉलेज इन ज्यूरिख. ही डिसाइडेड टू स्टडी एट अ यूनिवर्सिटी इन ज्यूरिख. बट साइंस वाजंट द ओनली थिंग दैट अपील टू द डैशिंग यंग मैन विथ वॉलरस मुस्टैच. इफ यू सी आइंस्टाइन्स फोटोग्राफ्स, his mustache is very different. Einstein का जो मूछ है mustache, वो थोड़ा हटके है, एकदम thick, walrus. So his mustache is very different. And yes, but science wasn't the only thing that appealed. Appealed means attracted this dashing young man. He was also very smart looking. So science was not the only thing that appealed to the dashing young man. You can see Einstein's photographs. The one to the left is when he was young, and one to the right is when he became old. You know, Einstein ka hi photograph hai. Ek jab wo young the aur ek Einstein in 1900, 21 saal ke umr ka photograph, aur aaj जैसे बूढ़े हो जाने के बाद. सो ही हैड अ वॉलरस मुस्टैच, डैशिंग पर्सनालिटी. ही आल्सो फेल्ट अ स्पेशल इंटरेस्ट इन अ फेलो स्टूडेंट मिलेवा मैरिक, हुम ही फाउंड टू बी अ क्लेवर क्रीचर. सो आइंस्टाइन आल्सो फेल इन लव विद अ लेडी हु यूज्ड टू स्टडी विद हिम. एंड व्हाट वाज द नेम ऑफ द लेडी in whom he started developing an interest? Mileva Marek. Mileva Marek was also a very clever lady, very intelligent lady. So Einstein was also intelligent, and he got attracted to a intelligent lady whose name was Mileva Marek. This young Serb had come to Switzerland because the university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees. So Mileva Marek, ye Einstein ki girlfriend ka naam hai. So she belonged to Serbia. She belonged to Serbia, and she had come to Switzerland to study. Why? Because in those days, there were not many colleges which admitted female students. Those days there was a lot of discrimination. Many universities did not admit female students. Even now, if you see in rural areas, still the discrimination is there between girls and boys. In urban areas it has become less, but तो उस समय जो था बहुत discrimination था. सारे colleges जो है वो ladies को admit नहीं करते थे, तो इसीलिए Zurich में पढ़ने आई थी Mileva, because it was one of the few universities in Europe where women could get degrees. Einstein saw in her an ally. Ally means friend. Against Philistines. To talk about people who did not like art, literature or music. Einstein was a scientist, but he also had an inclination, a liking for art and music. He played the violin throughout his life just for pleasure. So Einstein saw, hello, can you hear me, all of you? Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I'll send you the homework.
Yes, ma'am, on WhatsApp.
ये इस chapter में जितने भी new words सीखे हो सबका meaning और sentence बनाना. That is your homework. You have learned many new words. Freak, फिर ally, Philistines, और भी ये सब जितने भी न्यू वर्ड्स यू हैव कम अक्रॉस यू हैव टू राइट द मीनिंग्स एंड मेक सेंटेंसेस. Saw in her an ally against Philistines, those people in his family and at the university with whom he was constantly at odds. Constantly means continuously, regularly. At odds means have fights. Einstein ka jo hai bahut logon se tussle chalte rehta tha. Einstein had fights with many of the students and teachers because his way of thinking was very different. But Mileva and he shared the same kind of thoughts. Ek tarah ke vichar jo hai milte hain to aadmi dost banata hai. To Einstein ke saath bhi wahi tha. Uske aur Mileva ke thoughts bahut milte the. Both had interest in science, but both also had interest in art and music. There are many people who have interest in science, but they criticize art and music. Einstein was not like that. He loved mathematics and physics, but he also had interest in music. And Mileva was also the same kind of person. The couple fell in love. Letters survive in which they put their affection into words. So Mileva and आइंस्टाइन फेल इन लव. आज भी जो है आइंस्टाइन के द्वारा लिखे हुए लेटर्स जो है उसको बहुत प्रिजर्व करके रखा गया है क्योंकि आइंस्टाइन इज अ फेमस पर्सनालिटी. दैट इज व्हाई हिज लेटर्स हैव बीन प्रिजर्व. भाव्या आर यू प्रेजेंट? अटेंडेंस ले लेना. हेलो 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 भाव्या प्रेजेंट है? हेलो
यस मैम.
Attendance ले लेना. So this so हाँ तो letters that Einstein.
भाव्या प्रेजेंट नहीं है.
नहीं है तो तुम कौन बोल रही हो? तुम ही ले लो क्लास खत्म होने वाला है. 53 तो दिख रहा था कुछ देर पहले. You take the attendance. What's your name? आकृति. ओके आकृति यू टेक द अटेंडेंस.
यस मैम.
ओके सो लेट अस हैव यू टेकन. हेलो हेलो
यस मैम. यस मैम.